The big challenge is that most remote control cars are only designed to go 40 to 50 miles an hour. There's a lot of challenges to overcome. My name is James Beswick and I live in Bracknell in the UK. With the Ultimaker, its main purpose for me is to build the body shells. I can design in software a aerodynamic body. Especially with the extended, I can use a larger area. The main benefit is that I can create shapes with a printer that you cannot create easily with any other means. Now this would have to be a two-part print, whereas with the extended, I've been able to make it its full length, therefore eliminating a weak spot and making it a lot cleaner. The less joins, the more aerodynamic it is, the less disturbance you're going to get from the air. And it's all going to make a huge difference when they get to the end testing. Each time we run, we try and go a bit faster, we try a bit harder. There's always a challenge of wanting to go faster and wanting to go more. It's very addictive. Most of the challenge and the joy is designing the part and taking a part from a concept, essentially a prototype part to an end product, getting it on the car and actually using it. Because it's all very well to just think of something. It's another thing to have the first hand into building it, making it and running it. The good thing is it's out of the box thinking. I don't know anyone else that has thought to 3D print a body on a speed car. With a standard Lexan body, it's very flexible. So when the car's going at over 100 miles an hour, it will bend and deform. With a 3D printed car, you don't get that because you can set the thickness, you can set where the reinforcement parts. So you can essentially build a body to your specification that actually works. When you've built something yourself, you can put it down and it works how you want it to. I don't think you can beat that feeling.